Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and I'm coming to share with you today finished, and I'm gonna swap the name, finished life photo journal. I started to make these two books like a wedding photo album and a wedding guest book. I have used again my new tool, the brayer. This one, as you can see, it's still gold because I used a furniture or furnishing chalk for painting my pages in this journal, and also here in this journal a little bit. I have used furnishing gold paint, this Shabby Chic chalk based furniture paint. This one, oops, sorry, this one. And it's holding really well. It's like very, very strong painting. So I'm really glad I used that because it's beautiful color. This one, it's actually antique. I'm not sure. Yeah, this way. Antique gold. And it's a really gorgeous gold. So I have used that brayer to make my own pages. And I really love them. They look so amazing. This is kind of like abstract look. And I am so in love with this look. So I'm kind of using that brayer quite often now. I didn't expect that, but I'm glad I do use that. So this is stitching I used for this book. It was very fast to make. Oh, I do keep it upside down. I'm so sorry. These are pages from my new collection I created for this wedding book. Link will be down below. So I do have here my handmade painted gold, blue and kind of gray book pages. This should be like a guest book for wedding. And this I have created like a wedding photo album. But because... Just because it can be still used like photo album. I put inside pages, writing pages, but I kind of used that, elastic band holding. These are actually sewn together. Those pages are sewn like a signature together, so they are holding together beautifully. But in that journal, they are holding just with this elastic band, so all that signature can be take off. I used just these blue hand-painted pages are new. All that rest, it's from old books. They are proper vintage from my old ledger books, I mean. So all that rest, it's from very old books and all from collection with very old sketches from architects and engineers and stuff like that. And also from the music books. And I have decorated this book quite a lot. And I did enjoy it. I really did enjoy it. All that collection, link will be down below. Also, I will have there a link for vintage photos with garden party. I use these photos here just to show how beautifully this book can look with all those pictures with our family or friends or maybe pets, you know, or stuff we like to take a picture of. So I'm gonna start with this top cover. First I'm gonna show you. Here it's that switching thingy. And the cover has a light in it. And inside can be placed some picture because it can be opened this way. And it's large pocket here for beautiful picture, so it can be put inside. Here I made small decorations. This is from that new collection, and there are also these words. And I do have also a collection with vintage adverts. I will put all links down below. And I made these layouts just to decorate it, and I really did enjoy that. It was so refreshing to work with blue color and with kind of like clear not too much distressed look of this book. So it was, I really did enjoy it. So here we do have that switching technology for the cover. I do have here this one, I like decoration. Here I do have pockets with tags, so some notes can be placed there. Here I do have beautiful window frame with this photography. And I used for that frame my collage paper to make it kind of like to match together from all kind of papers, from offcuts, with the book pages, with a gray color and also with a blue color. I made collage sheet and then I use it for my window frames. I do have quite lots of them here as well. For all of them I use those collage sheets because I think those frames then look so beautiful. So I do have here that frame with a photography inside, and here we have kind of like sliding spot here, and I do have that this beautiful ephemera and tag, and then we have one pocket here and another pocket here, and I do have their frames, few frames, so some pictures can be glued together with this, and maybe some a small note on it. So I do have there also frames from my collage sheets, and here you can see I used all kind of offcuts. Also from my Breyer papers. They are here. Here I do have this photography with a garden party. And here I do have this beautiful picture and this tag. I do have also a link for these tags. There is a collection of 12, yeah, I think 12 tags with this decorative old design. I'm gonna move it a little bit up so you can see. And this is closing with this string closure. And here, in this first page, so we have handmade paperclip, like typewriter key, because I just do love that look. It's open like this, space maybe for a picture or for some journaling, space for some journaling, and it's opening like this. So we have beautiful decorative paper. Here I do have another tag from that collection, and here we have a pocket with these mini labels, and they can be like a journaling spot, and we have some ephemera here. Hey, come here, yeah, it's there. Some ephemera here. And we do have another pocket with another ephemera. And one more pocket, it's here with these ephemeras. And here I used one of these words. They are with this collection. Just a few words. And it's closing with this ribbon. So that's first kind of spread or layout, and anywhere can be placed photos or some memorabilia. Here we do have large pocket, and in that background you can see those papers from this collection. Here I do have like slide spot and this picture. And it can be like journaling spot, or you can put there some photography. Then lift it up, another journaling space here. Here we do have a space for photography or for some journaling. And again, lift it up and maybe space for journaling. And here we do have another beautiful ephemera. And again, lift it up and you have journaling spot or place for photography. Sorry. And here another space. And in that pocket, I'm gonna slide the lady back. And I used again for decorating, I used those vintage adverts here as well. And in that pocket, I do have this beautiful picture and another tag. And I really like the look of this book. It's simple. Oh, I forgot to place it somewhere. Where it was? It was here. It's just simple spread, but it looks so amazing. And if you will imagine to have there pictures of your family, I think it will look so beautiful. And if you will take all of these vintage ephemera off and put there just pictures, it will be a really beautiful album. I mean photo album. If I will take it off, you do have very clean design, so any kind of modern pictures can be up there. I'm gonna just slide it back. Here and here and photo. So here we have writing pages, and again I use that gold and blue and a little bit of gray. And here I do have those vintage papers. Another tag from my collection of vintage tags. And they are very simple designs, but beautiful designs. They can be added to any kind of theme. These from my rusty paperclip again, handmade paperclip with that typewriter key. And these, and it's in very light blue, this one. And then is also a collection of 12 tags in brown, in like that vintage brown. So another ephemera, writing pages. And here I do have, again from leftovers, cut out frame, and it's just like journaling spot. And papers for writing. And I think I somehow managed to move my elastic band. So these are from my ledger books, and those ledger books are really gorgeous. So writing pages, and it can be take off from that journal. This way, sit down. So here we do have another spread of pages. I do have here in this tag spot, I do have this beautiful picture and tag with the paper clip. And here all these photo mats, I'm gonna call them photo mats because I made them that way, they are holding with this moving tab. And I do have here another tag. And it can be lift up, so it's their journaling space. And here is kind of like a tag spot. And again, lift it up and it's journaling space. Here is big space for some writing or for some photography. And this can be lift up as well. So you have also tag spot here behind this beautiful a vintage advert. I'm losing my English, I'm so sorry. And it can be opened this way. And here we have again a pocket and these photo mats for writing or for pictures. And here we have pocket with some beautiful ephemera. I'm gonna slide this behind to hold these photo mats. And here on this page, I do have just this side pocket all over of that space, so some bigger pictures or some large documents can be slider. And also every single of these large pages, they do have a big pocket right here for some big documents or something you wanna save there. And on this spread, I do have pocket here on the top with this ephemera, and again with few labels put together like journaling space. And again, I made them. These are actually from those frames, so I use them here like my mini booklet. And when we open this one, we have pocket here, and again my Brayer paper, and we have kind of like slide spot and this beautiful picture, and it's lifting up, lifting up, lifting up, and lifting to the side, so you have nice big space here. And all these can be used like journaling spot or for pictures, any way you want. And it's closing again with this string. Like this. And again, if you will take off all these vintage ephemeras and photos, you can use it like a modern photo album. And here we have kind of a repeating page, so we do have those two tags as a closure. Here is a small pocket. Is there or it's not? Yes, it's there. There is a small pocket here. And we have another paperclip, handmade paperclip with this beautiful photo, and it's journaling space or a photo mat, lifting up. Here a lifting down to one side and up. So we have space here, space here, here maybe writing journaling spot. I think it was here. Now I don't remember where I have it. I think it was here. Now I'm not sure. I'm gonna just slide it here to make sure it will hold. And this one there. And I use those beautiful acetate butterflies like decoration, because I think they make it so soft, so romantic. And again, pocket here, all page pocket here with this beautiful picture, and another ephemera here, this beautiful picture. And this is offcut from these frames. So here you can see my collage paper, and here again from that collage paper I do have a frame here. Again, I use those vintage adverts to decorate that frame. And we've got another three photo mats, and this another design from this collection. It's very soft. It's proper. I think it's proper. In my mind, it's proper wedding, because it has that blue, and I think it's saying in English language that something blue, something borrow something blue, if I'm not mistaken. How I have it? You've been there, have you? This way, and the butterfly. And tuck. So it's in that pocket there. And again, a large pocket here. On this page, we do have this moving tab, which is holding all kind of ephemeras in this pocket. Again, that frame with that acetate. And here I do have another tag, this tag spot, and photo mat lifting up and lifting to the side. So here is nice space, big space. And I think I'm gonna hold it here like this. Like this. And in that pocket we do have this beautiful butterfly and a ephemera. Now go there. And again, opening page. And we do have pocket here on the top with ephemera. We do have pocket here. And we do have photo mat here with this gentleman. So photo mat here. It was upside down, this beautiful picture. So photo mat is here and here and here. So it's like waterfall. I'm gonna place it this way and this way and close it together. And again, I do have here that handmade paper clip with that typewriter key. And when you open it, we have again this simple pocket on the side with these ephemeras and this beautiful picture. It's all about that garden party. I actually think that garden party is perfect for wedding. So I guess that's why I place it together. So here we have so many ephemeras, and we do have again the closure, that tab closure. And when I open it, I do have this accordion style of page, and it can be picture put on these two sides or here. Here I do have like a pocket, and it's also a pocket behind. And here we have one photo mat, this journaling spot, and another journaling spot. And again, all these decorative papers. I'm gonna slide these. And put the ladies here and close it with my tab. And again, large pocket here. On this page I do have again a very simple spread, and I just made a knot. Bear with me, please. shoot. Oh, come on. So it's holding with this tab, and we do have photo mat here, and again another paper clip and this beautiful picture, and it's photo mat here. And another photo mat here. And again, frame, that acetate window frame. And I do have here this mini picture. I'm gonna slide it this way. And the lady here. And I do have here these two ephemeras. Oh, look at me. There you are. And again, here writing pages, and I used again so many pages from my vintage ledger papers. So it's full. Good. full with those ledger papers, another typewriter key, and mini booklet. So writing pages, and again it's holding on that elastic band, and we are nearly on the end. So here I do have again this moving tab and accordion pocket. Looks like this. I do have pocket here at the front, behind this beautiful advert, and there is pocket here. I do have that this ephemera, and we have 1, 2, and 3 photo mats or journaling space. And I used again a handmade paper clip and this beautiful picture. And it's holding with this tab, and when I open it, I do have here this, it's kind of like multi pocket. I do have that window pocket here, there it's triple pocket here, 1, 2, 2 and 3, and I do have another pocket here, and there is that large pocket all the way down there. So it's on this page, and here we've got again that window frame pocket, and again tag spot with this beautiful picture here, these ephemeras, and another photo mats. Lift up and lift to the side, and nice big space. And on the next side, we do have another opening. And pocket here on the top. By the way, these gray pictures and these beautiful small ephemeras like this, they are from Pinterest. I found them on Pinterest. They was colorful, totally colorful, all of them. But because I made this journal in that with my gray labels, I printed out black and white. I kind of need to match it. So we do have window pocket here. And I do have that these ephemeras, these are from the pocket here on the top. I'm so sorry, I'm jumping kind of here. So there is pocket here on the top, another pocket here. And we do have a photo mat or journaling spot here. Again, that Breyer paper, I use it for making my envelopes. And here I do have this and the tag again. That soft bluish tack. It's here, and it's holding with this. Go there. Go there. And this is the last page. Here is last page, and here I do have this beautiful page here. Let's lift it up, and I do have one pocket here with that window, one pocket behind that window, one pocket here on the bottom, and I do have that this picture and these ephemeras. These are from Pinterest. And another large pocket. Another large pocket. It's all the way down there behind all these pictures. And I do have that these. These are those kind of bluish tags I've got. And this is from Pinterest. So these are my pages in the live photo journal. I'm gonna call that live photo journal, and I forgot to close it here. Look at me. Okay, I need to take this one off, close it, and then slide it in. Alright. So this is my small journal. Here is kind of similar closure as it was on the front. So just lift it up and you can slide some picture inside. And this is my life photo journal. Thank you so much for visiting me today. I hope you found some inspiration. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me. Have a beautiful day. Take care about yourself and I will see you soon. Bye.